It is an honour for me as Taoiseach to mark this significant moment in contemporary Irish history. It was on the 22nd of January, 50 years ago, at the Palais d'Egmont in Brussels, that the then Taoiseach, the late Jack Lynch, along with the then Minister for Foreign Affairs and later President of Ireland, Dr. Patrick Hillary, signed the treaty on behalf of Ireland to join the then European communities. It set in train a process that saw the Irish people vote by an overwhelming 83% in favour of joining the EEC in May 1972, and ultimately Ireland become a member state on the 1st of January 1973. Few events in our history as an independent state have been so transformative. The 5 decades since that signing ceremony in Brussels have witnessed Ireland emerge as a modern open economy and society, a country that contributes to and benefits from the close relationship and cooperation we enjoy with our European partners. Far from diminishing our sovereignty as a people, our membership of the European Union has helped to strengthen it. With our partners, we have transformed not just this country, but the continent that is our shared home. Our membership of the European Union gives us a reach and an influence that we would not otherwise enjoy, underpinning Ireland's deeply positive participation in 21st century networks of global economic and political cooperation. On that day, 50 years ago, not all were positively disposed to the new possibilities that joining the European communities would open. Our newly found independence, just 50 years old, was fragile and jealously guarded. There were those who urged caution against entry and who worried that pooling our sovereignty would undermine rather than strengthen it. Irish industry and agriculture in particular faced unknown risks. The concerns about entry were legitimate ones. They were raised by people who wanted the best for Ireland. But those convinced that Ireland's future lay in Europe showed considerable courage, a courage to imagine a new Ireland and a more confident and optimistic future. As Jack Lynch said at the time, it was a courage to respond, to quote the call made by the founding members to other countries of Europe who shared their ideals, to join in their efforts to establish the foundations of an ever closer union among the European peoples. This included not least the ideal of a vital force for peace in the world and an ever-increasing contribution to the economic and social progress of developing nations. As is so often the case, the courageous decision was the right decision. The optimism of Ireland's entry was in many ways mirrored by a similar optimism in the 6 founding members. They too saw a potential in our country that perhaps we did not yet fully see in ourselves. These past 50 years have seen a transformative and overwhelmingly positive impact of European Union membership across all dimensions of our society. The generations since accession have enjoyed immense opportunity on a scale perhaps unimaginable to our predecessors in the Ireland of 1972. The freedom to travel, to live, to study, and to work across all of the European Union has in turn nurtured the richest of bonds, of friendship, of family, of trust between Ireland and our European neighbours. A young Irish state transitioned from relative economic stagnation and insularity to embrace economic openness, a place at the heart of the single market, and a competitive and attractive location for global investment. We unleashed an energy of Irish creativity and entrepreneurial spirit without precedent. It was a transformation supported by our European partners, not least through substantial transfers of structural funding. Our European Union membership has also played a vital role in the journey towards peace and reconciliation on this island. For as long as the United Kingdom was a fellow member state, Europe provided a valuable shared space in which Irish and British ministers could cooperate and get to know each other. Relationships forged through this contact helped to develop the mutual trust and understanding that were so important throughout the peace process. Our European partners also made their contribution through the strongest and most steadfast of support, a support that continues today through the generous European Union support for peace and reconciliation programmes benefiting communities north and south and strengthening prosperity across this island. They have stood by Ireland as we have worked together to manage the unique challenges for this island resulting from the United Kingdom's decision to leave the European Union, making the objective of sustaining peace, avoiding a hard border and protecting the all-island economy a major priority from the very beginning of negotiations. Sitting at the European Union table has exposed Ireland to new ideas and to new, more generous and compassionate ways of thinking. Membership gave us the impetus we needed as a nation to strengthen our human rights record, to drive forward civil and social rights, to introduce gender equality legislation, to improve protection of workers' rights, and to become a much more tolerant, kinder and inclusive country than the Ireland of 1972. We now play our part in seeking to advance and defend the Union's shared values: respect for human dignity, freedom, democracy, equality, the rule of law and respect for human rights within the Union and indeed throughout the world. We are proud to be part of a Union in which pluralism, non-discrimination, tolerance, justice, solidarity and equality are valued, nurtured and never taken for granted. We are proud that Ireland has become a beacon to others of what the European Union can help a country to achieve, never more so than when we welcomed 10 new member states to the Union on a memorably sunny day in Dublin in May 2004, a day when Seamus Heaney called for us to, quote, move lips, move minds, and make new meanings flare. His words continue to inspire us to shape an optimistic perspective for the future, despite the many challenges we face together. The story of Ireland in the European Union is one that bears telling and retelling. It is a story that lends profound credibility to the European Union's claim to be a force for progress and for good. As we reflect upon it over the coming months, as we contribute to the Conference on the Future of Europe, currently considering how the Union should progress, I hope that we will share the optimism, aspiration and hope that informed those who signed this treaty for Ireland 50 years ago. It is time for a new generation of Irish Europeans to make new meanings flare and to bring a fresh imagination to the European project for the next 50 years. Over the next year to 18 months here in Ireland, we will mark some of the significant milestones on the road to our membership. We will take this opportunity to encourage reflection, debate and exchange on the Ireland-European Union relationship and how we can best contribute to a strong and shared future. Today is a day to celebrate our history in the European Union. It is a proud day to be Irish, to be European. Desh isha an lá seo, lenor star sonetos orbacha a chelúra, bímish broduil as a bheith éirinach agus orbach. God of mille mille maha guiv galair.